So in Python, there is a lot of GUI frameworks give you the ability to, but there is only one framework which give you the ability to make cross-platform applications. This is the Kivy framework. So Kivy is the only available GUI framework in the Python market which give you the ability to make an applications for Linux, Mac. So Kivy give you the ability to make cross-platform applications and proved usability to make an multi-touch applications. And inside this class, we will see how we can make an application for Android. In this training workshop, we will explain the basic tools on how you can make your own layouts and how you can make and themes for the Kivy frameworks. Finally, we'll explain how you can export your application to run on Android or on iOS. So if you want to build an application for Android, you must have a Linux system. If you want to build an application for iOS, you must have a Mac. We'll explain how to make a calculator. We'll explain how to make a login screen. We'll explain how to make a stopwatch and a lot of examples introduced inside this class. So I hope you enjoy this training workshop. Let's dive into the course. Hello and welcome. So today we are going to see how we can install the Kivy framework. So this is the official website for the Kivy. And if you want to get to the download page, you can see that there is a lot of install processes according to the operating system. And we will use the installation on Windows. So there is the three steps for install Kivy. First, you should make an virtual environment and then activate the virtual environment, and after that install these dependencies. So if you are in Linux or in Mac or any platform, there is some dependencies to install the Kivy. So firstly, install any of these layer, and secondly this line, and after that you can, if you see an error, then you install this dependencies, which is Angle. And finally, install Kivy, which is around 14 megabyte. There is an option, optional choice for installing the examples. But after installing the Kivy of version 1.11.1, then we are ready to start our first lesson. Today, we are going to explore the Kivy and make our first application. So firstly, we will open a file, and this will be the intro.py. And after that, we will import the Kivy. So we will import the Kivy, and Kivy dot require 1.8.0. So if there is an library of Kivy below this version, so it will not work. As you can see, we are now working in the version of 1.11.1. So after that, we will import the application. So from kivy.app, we will import the app class, and from kivy.ux.label, import the label. And after that, we will make an class. So we must have an application, and this application will inherit from the app. And then we have the build function, which is we will override and going to use it to say that we have a label. So the text will be hello or anything, and after that finally we will run. So if you divide our first lesson, firstly, we import here, import required classes or libraries, and then define main class, which is my app, and after that, run application, run the application. So this is the basics of any simple application. And after that, if main will be, I think we, if name here then application.run. So now we are ready to going to the command line. As you can see, I have activated the environment, and then I must go to the folder which I have installed, or I have make this file into, and then I will type Python 3 or Python, as you, as in the environment only one Python is installed. So Python we are here intro.py. So after that we should see this screen, and it say that it's called name, and after that let's going to rerun. So as you can see we are here, and as you can see this is the label. As you can see, any label in located inside the UIX library folder, and we are now making a simple label as you can see. So in the next video we are going to see how we can make a button inside the Kivy. So before making explaining the widgets inside the Kivy, we will see how we can make a simple login screen with username and password. So let's get started by making a new file, and we will call it lesson2.by, and after that we will import the Kivy language. So we have imported from kivy.app the app function, and we will import also from uix.label. We will import the label with capital L, which is a class, and also from kivy.uix.grid layout we will import the grid layout, and also we will import from kivy.uix.text input we will import the text input, and after that we will make the first class. So in our application we have two classes, the first one which is the login screen, the second which is application. So first one which is called login screen inherits from grid layout, and after that we will say define init self keywords super. This is a constructor, we will explain that in a moment. So this is a class, and we are inherited from the grid layout, and we are saying that this is an constructor. When we initialize this grid layout, there is some parameters, maybe buses to the layout. So we are constructing the basic layout for the login screen. So self dot columns will be 2, and self dot add widget so we are saying that we have two columns. The first column will have a username and label, so we will add and after that self dot add widget for the class, and we will add then we are defining the username which is a text input, and then we add this username to our widget. So we have now a label, and we have a username which is the text input. And we can now copy these lines because we have the password. So add a widget, and the label will called the password. Multi line will be the false, and password will be true. And self dot add widget self dot here password. And after that, we have now defined the our login screen. There is any no buttons yet, so let's make our application. Inherit from the app. Define build of self, and let's return login screen. Let's run our application. So we have a class which is called the application, which holds the login screen. The login screen is a grid layout, contains two lines. First line is which contains the label and the username, and second line is the password, which is a label and another text input. And let's run our application now. Going here and say listen2.py, and after that it says that the login screen isn't defined, so let's see in the alright, so I think it's login screen. Let's run again. So the second error here, we have self.password and here self.username. Let's try again and see what we will get. And there is another error here in the multiline. We have mistyped the multiline. So I will go again and try to run so the same true isn't defined. And I think it's called true and a lot of errors in our application. Let's run again. So this is our main GUI. Here is the password and here is the password and here is the username. So that concludes for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next video. Alright, so this is the third lesson. We will going to start a new file and we will call it lesson3.by and we will explain how we can make a button. So we will import as usual the KIVI and all the necessary file. We will use also the label and we will copy this and going here and define some classes. So we will add a widget from kivi.uix.widget, import the widget. And we have a class called we can call it third widget, inherits from widget, and we will pass for now. Let's say we have third app, inherits from application. We will pass for now, and you will say if name will be then third app dot run. So there is KIVI is depending on Python, or you can use an external describing language called the KIVI. So if you going to the packages here, you can search for KIVI and you will see the KIVI language. You can install any of these add-on, then the support for the KIVI inside your application will be supportable or quick to use the KIVI language. Then you can start a file called cert.kivi. So the KIVI language must have the same name of your application without the app, and it must be all on small case small letters and it will be defined already by Python if it is in your file directory. So these are the three notes for you. Then I will go on to describe some lines inside this widget. I will define that there is an insert widget. And then skip by tab key. I will say that I have a label tab and say that the ID will be called label 1. And position will be 300 and 200. And the text will be maybe hello. Then we have another button. Is this a button? So we have another widget which is called the button. The ID will be button 1. So you may ask why we are using the ID. So you can reference this ID inside your Python file to make an event which we will talk about later. And we have the position 200 and 300. We have the size which is 350. We have the text which is hello. And we have the function which is called onBress. And on this Bress we will call dot root which is our application and dot my callback. Root dot my callback. And we will again say that we have a text input. And inside this text input, which is another widget, and make sure that you have the text input all as you type here. So if you have label, you type label, and if you have widget, you type widget. If you have button, you type button. So you are typing here inside this thread. You are typing the name of your class. Let's say that we have an ID, and this ID will be called text input 1. We have the position of 200 and 400, and we have a size of 350. We have a multi line of false, and we have a text which is called add. And after that, on focus root dot my. So in focus, we will make these functions. So we will return it to our Python file, and inside the widget we will type a function. So we will type the first so self.ids.label1. Dot text you have clicked here now, and after that we have another function which is called my callback 1 which is an inherits from self which is our widget dot IDs dot label 1 dot text will be enter text here. So let's define what we will get. So if you focused in the label, you will see the text. If you clicked on the button, you will changing the label. So these are two events that you should run return third widget not running so third widget only we are returning the third widget and after that I will go to the timeline and say that this is called lesson 3 so I will type lesson 3 and then enter. Then we should see this panel. So after typing, clicking here, we'll see that you have clicked here. And while focusing, you can see there is two arguments buses. So I think that there is some input here. So we must say input string of input. Let's try this again. I will run. Let's focus, as you can see. Then the label have another input. And if you click here, you have clicked now. If you focused, so this is the basics. If you click, you have clicked. If you focus, you see that there is an we are making an space. So this is the basic. If you click, you will see this. If you focus on the text input, you will see so this is very very useful part inside the key. As you can see, this is the third lesson. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next lesson. Hello and welcome. My name is Kenneth Tommy and I will be your instructor inside this class. So today we are going to see how we can make an widgets that you can add or remove buttons from your layout. So we will start a new file which is called lesson4.py, and inside this lesson we will copy the same widget from here that we use in all applications, and we will also from kv.uix.button we will import the button class, and after that we will say that we have force widget inherits from widget and then bus. We have also class force app inherits from application and again bus, and this is the final line inside our application. We will run the force app dot run, and we will going to make another force dot kv which is this name, and let's firstly add a widget. So we explaining that we have a widget here which is the force widget. We have a label. You must make a space which is four spaces, and as you can see, if you see here, you can see that this is the KV language because we are installing an extension. So we have a label, then we have a text. For this label, you can type in this text as you'd like. We have an ID which is called label 1, and we have a position which is called 300 and 200. And after that, we will go to our button file to add some functionality. So for our widget, we will see that we have a function called define on touch down self and inherits from touch. After that, we will add a widget. This widget is a button. Text will be a string of touch dot position, and again inside this button we have the position will be touch dot position. and if touch dot is double tap we will remove this widget. And if touch is triple tab, we will clear these widgets. So here is an error. We should now define build. And after that return force widget. So I think we are now ready for running the app. So I will kill the previous one and type here lesson4.py. And it say here touch.position. Touch.position. We have button it's text. Will display the position argument which is x and y. Let's say it's not defined. So force alright. So if you touch here, you see that there is some arguments that isn't passed correctly. So there was an error here. So this is an position, not. There was an error here. This is the position, not BOD. And let's run again. We should here see. So it called. And again, I will remove these brackets and let's run again to see what we have. So we will make a button such as this. And if you say weekly reference object no longer exists, let's type again. I add a button and two tab to clear the label, three tab kill the application. It should clear widgets, not kill the application. Let's try again one time. The first method working correctly. The second method working also correctly. And we should have the triple tab self dot clear. Widgets I think that there is an error because the label doesn't exist. I will try to run this application in the smartphone to see if I can run this correctly. So you should have a basic knowledge of how you can add widgets using the add widget function, or you can remove widgets such as this, or you can remove the all widgets in your canvas by using this function. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next lesson. Thanks a lot for joining me inside this class, and inside this tutorial we're going to see how we can using the screen manager to make a widget that you can swap as you can see inside any smartphone. So as usual we will import the application. So from kv.app import app. So this is will be an advanced lesson. You should follow along and watch all the other previous tutorials. We will import the builder and from kv dot label we will import the label class. We will also import the button class. We will import the box layout and also we will import the screen. So let's define what we have. We have imported the label, we have imported from kv.ux, we have import the button, we have import the box layout, we have import the screen. And after that we will define that we have an middle button or anything. Pass for now because we will define in the kv. And we have the fifth widget. This inherits from the widget. And we will define an constructor. And it's called super. And 4 L in letters. We want to make 5 buttons and we want to make 5 screens and we want to make 5 labels. So I think if we go here and add or make a list for I will type my name. Maybe typing so after that these are the names that we will add. So for all in letters inside this list we will make an screen. So this will be an screen and name will called be the L and inside this screen we should add an widget. It's called it's an label of course and the text will be also the L and after that self dot IDs dot screen manager dot add widget self dot IDs dot buttons dot add widget text will be L. So we have added an widget which is the screen. The widget has 5 screens. Each 5 screens has a text of the each screen has only one button. And this application will return the fifth widget. And if name equals main, then we will run the fifth app dot run. All right. I think now we will start to define the layout inside the kv. So we will go here and type another file, which is fifth.kv. And again, we will say that we have the fifth widget. And inside this one, we have orientation. To be vertical, and we have the box layout and we have the height and we have ID, which is buttons, and we have the screen manager ID calls SM, then we have of course the button M button, so on press app dot root dot IDs dot SM dot current will be self dot text. So let's explain this. We have an box layout which is called the button, and we have the screen manager. So inside, where is the lesson 5? So here inside is each screen has only one button, and if we clicked on this button, it will go to the screen which have the same name, because we have defined the same name to be the same name. So it will go to the screen which have the name to be this name of the button. So let's go to run our application 5.py. And it's called a widget isn't defined because we have to import from kv.uix.widget. And I think if we using the box layout, it will be much, much better. So I will using here the instead of widget, I will using the box layout. So basically the box layout, it's take all the buttons to the screen. So let's see what we will get. It's called so we have missed or forget to add here the star, and let's to the command line and run our application to see what we have. And it say sober object has new attribute get attribute box layout, and here is the and also here M button to be the same as here M button. Let's run to see if we can run, and as you can see we have the same. I think there is some error, so there was an error here. So return fifth widget, and alright, so I found that the error was inside this widget. The name of the widget wasn't correct. So make sure that the type or the text matches correctly. So let's go here and run, and we will say that these are the layout. This is box layout, and each time you click on these panels, you will see that there is a screen which is swapping between these screens. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next lesson. Right, so this will be a quick tip on how we can edit or visualize text inside the KV. So we have the defined build of self, and we will return, let's go back, and we will return a label, and this label will be has text will be hello, and the second word will be world. So we will define the color,
like this. We have color, like inside HTML we have the color, and inside this tag we can say color will be here. We want it to be red, so 0 in R, 0 in red, green, blue, and I think FF in blue. And we have now also the the reference. So why we are making this, I will say it now. We have also here the reference. We have the reference and you have the color. The tag must be, or it should be better to be small. And we have the text, and after that we say that mark up will be true. Why is this? Because we are using the HTML tag, we are want to include the markup inside this text. All right, how we can specify the font size? Like this, font size will be 80. And let's run our file. We have it. So Python will be, we are going to run tutorial 03.py. Anyway, what we have here, we have the world inside. It has, so we have all the text to be font size of 80, and we have this one is colored to be blue. As we have stated here, we have said that we have color of blue, and we have also the color to be blue, and we have the reference. So we want it the reference to be world, because we are reference to the world. We are editing the world word. So basically we will rerun this file to see what we will get to remove this reference. So we will now have get it correctly. How we can change the font? So easily, you can specify another argument here after font size. You can say font name will be Droid Sans, like this. And again we will run our file, and I think it didn't work. Make sure that you have typed any font that you have inside your machine. So I will type Source Sans Brew, and let's get I will run the file again, and the font isn't found. And let's go back, and I think we have Source Sans Pro. I will rerun again to see if I have the font. Also, the font didn't exist, so maybe trying Myriad Bro. Make sure that you have typed any font that you have inside your machine. Let's go back, and so the file doesn't. So because this isn't working up to this moment, the font type. So we'll try something different. So we will try to. Let's close all these terminal. So I will say that we have font name will be I am not sure if the KV support the OTF fonts or not. Basically I will type it now. And let's test it for a moment. Font name will be self.font name, and we will run this for a moment to see. So right, the font name has been worked correctly, and as you can see, we have the source. The new font has been up. So this is also another font inside the same directory, and we will save this file to test the new font also. And let's close out the panel and let's see. So this is the font which is Firecode, and I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in the next tutorial. So in this lesson, we are going to see how we can customize our app. The app function inside Kivy, which is have imported in the third line here. This app module has a lot of functions that you can use inside your app. So let's get started by making a new file. This file will be tutorial. And firstly, we can import all these files. So we have to import all these files, and we have imported the app, and maybe we want to import the label, and after that we can define our app. We may use the box layout, so I will import for just for demonstration. And after that, I will define that we have a window, which is a new window like this new window, and it will be inherited from the box layout. And after that, we will pass like this. We have no argument up to this moment, and this isn't defined. This is the class, so we will delete all this. And again, we can now. Class first app, this maybe define it, and it inherits from the app. And again, we will override some functions. So to use app, we have first, which is the build, and we have build of self. We can say that we have self dot titled. This will be the title of your app if you are using it to make a desktop application. And let's say that we have a new custom title, and in the old versions of Kivy, self.icon may work for you. You will define that you have icon 1.png, but in this version this will not work. If you make it like this, it will not work. So you can go here in the first line and say icon before the build, say icon without the self, icon equals this, and it will work in the latest version from 1.8 and 1.9 and 1.10 and 1.11. All this method will work from all versions after 1.8. And after that, we can say that we now want to return new window if the build, if you are building the app, you will return to this widget, and we are now done. So we have also on start function, we will override this function and say print hello, and after that we will return true if it so every function build on start or any function defined on stop. Also, we have also defined on resume. So basically, in the app, we have the most four important functions. We have the build, we have the on start, we have the on stop, we have on resume. All these will be functions that you must return something. If you don't return something, you can print. So I will inherit from here, and I will print any statement like good luck or bye, and after that I will pass like this to not return anything. Any resume is used, you can use if an error happen to your class or to your app. So if there is some error, everything is working correctly. Alright, and we will pass again on stop has been done and on resume, and let's go back and we now have the time to run our file. Alright, now we can call this method and we will see this image, but we have typed the file not correctly to you. Alright, so firstly we have seen the hello, which is starting or getting from on start. So our app has been successfully started, and if you close you will see that some message will appear here. So the on start and on stop has been working correctly inside our app. You can use this on start to use to put an image on the start, or use for splash screen, and also you can use a timer or clock etc helper, and you can use this on start to put an splash screen on inside your app, which we will make inside or in the next video. Alright, hello everyone, welcome. So in this video we're going to make something different, and we will make this gallery. And as you can see, we have this simple app. We have three images, and we can swap to this by sliding from left to right or right to left. So we will customize these images, and I have used some default images. And now let's get started by making this app. So firstly we will create a new file, and we will name I will name this file to be third.by. Then we will start from firstly we will import the library, which is Kivy, and Kivy dot require the minimum version, which will be 1.2.0. Then after that we will from Kivy dot app we will import the main app as like this, and we must import this app to run your file. Without this is maybe obligatory for your run of the file, and if you didn't import this statement you will not run your file anymore. And after that we will try to import we use some widgets. So I will import the main widget, which is here, and make sure you type this W to be capital, and this will be capital, and as you can see all these are small letter cases. And after that from the kv.factory we will import the factory capital. And after that also from kv we have some errors, but let's skip it for now. We want want also the carousel, so we will import the carousel. So we have some error here. This is factory. After we have imported the important library, we can go here and make a class. So this class will be any name, but make sure you have type capital first, and maybe my first window like this, and it will inherit from widget, but I don't want to inherit from widget. I want to get the box layout. So from, make sure you have typed it correctly, from kv.uix.carousel we want the, not the carousel, the box layout. So from the box layout we want to import box layout. Alright, then we will inherit from the box layout, and after that we will define that we have some initialization, and this is the constructor. So define init, and first argument is self, and second argument is some keywords, and this is the constructor. So sober, if any child will inherit from this my first window, we will initialize it to get some keywords also. So this is our constructor, and after that we have missed here the this character, and after that we want we have some carousel. So we'll define that we have a carousel, and this carousel, let's go back, and this carousel will have the direction to be the right, and after that we have floor I in range of 3. We will import something. We will say that we have a source image defined in image, and this will be an integer dot jpeg, and we will use here the I. So we have image 1, image 2, image 3, image 4, image 5, and after that we have the image itself. So we have defined the source, but we have the image, which is async image. So why we have used async image? So async image is actually used also from kv.uix.async image. You can import the async image. You can import from the factory, and you can import from the UIX. And after that, we will import this image, and we have the source to be src, and we have allow stretch to be true. After that we can add the carousel. We can add the image to the carousel simply by adding using the add widget function, and we will add the image. After that, after 3 times, we have 3 images only. If you have more, you can define this number. If you have around 20 image, you can adjust it to be 20 like this, and make sure that this I starts from 0, not 1. So make sure that you have typed it correctly. And after that, after we have added the 3 images, so after that we can go to self.add widget. So this box layout will contain the carousel, like this carousel, and again make sure that you have the self like this. Alright, after that we can go and start our the app. So we will say class third app, inherit from app, define, we will override the build function, define build of self, return this my first window, and after that if we want to run our file, so if name have the same name of the function, we will say third app dot run. Alright, let's go back and save our file. We have everything correctly. I will go back here and close this old one and say Python 3, and we have the name, which is third.py. Let's run this file. So we have something error here. So we have this. So let's go back and rerun, and it say that. So make sure that you have type one semicolon like this, and one quote like this. Again, we can go back and try to run our file, and it say that the sober has no attribute my first window. I think also we have some errors in the here. So that dot init like this. Anyway, let's rerun our app, and it has image 1. to the right. So we have defined here the direction to be the right, and again we can swap to the right or to the left, and we have only three images. And this is the right dimensions, and as you can see, we have make it correctly. So in the next video, we will see how we can use the .kv language to make this instead of using these functions, or we will use some kv file. So let's go start from the first lesson. So writing the first app inside Kiwi is very, very simple. Let's get started by making an sample app. So we will start by using sample.py to generate some new file. And firstly, we will import the Kiwi, which is the main library. And you can also, this is optional, to make Kiwi.require. And this is the minimum version you can start from. And we will start from Kiwi.app. This is an obligatory, as I have said, this is an obligatory module that you should import. And from kv.uix, let's go back .uix.label, we want to import the label. And we want also from kv.uix.box layout, we want to import the box layout, and make sure that you have typed it all in small. Anyway, we have to make a window. So this is main window, which is inherits from box layout. And again, we can use the instructor defined in it from self and some keyword arguments, and using the super to init the arguments. Again, we will say that we have some label. So we can say that we have lb, it will be equal to label, and text will be maybe click here or anything. And after that, we will self.add widget. Self is a box layout, which is a menu or widget, and we will add another widget, which is the lb. And after that, we can go back to create an app, which is an class to run our module. So let's go back and create a main app. And after that, we will inherit from the app, and we will say that we have define build. So this will override the build function, which is inside the app. And you will say that return when we want to build our app, we will return to this main menu, which is has all the stuff we want to show in our screen. So we'll return main window like this, and make sure that you have typed it correctly. Finally, we want to run our script. So if main equal this will be the main, and we want it to run by using main app dot run such as this. And I think we are now done, and let's go back also, and let's we are using this one. So I will exit from the script, and again I will type Python 3, and we want to run it, which is sample.py, and its no module is KIV. So we have some mistyped error. So I will rerun again, and we have it. So we self isn't defined. So if you have seen the error, which is here, self isn't defined, make sure that you have tabbed, make sure that you have this function inside the initialization inside the constructor. And again, I will run our file, and it's showing this label, which is here. and in and it's to work perfectly. So let's move to the next step, and we want to make some buttons. So from kv.uix.button we will import the button like this, and we have to say that we have another button which is here. btn will be a button, and let's say that the text will be click or maybe new button, any text like this. And we want to add also after the label we want to add the btn which is our button. And again I will save the file and let's see what we will get after that. I have saved and let's see. So we have this button and we have this label and all are responsive. You can use in any screen, and this is a benefit from using some framework such as this. Alright, we are now done, and to be honest there is a lot of options and we will discuss later. And let's go to the next step, and in the next lesson we'll see how you can implement an KV language. So the benefit from KV language is that you can separate the logic from the UI. So you can using the KV language to make an interface which is in separate file .kv like this. And there is some limitation from using all this. It can be done if you are using only simple screen, but for a large app you should separate the UI from the logic. I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in the next lesson. So in a previous video we have seen how we can making an image gallery using the basic tools and KV. And inside this video we're going to see how we can load an image from the internet. So the procedure is pretty straightforward, and firstly we will make a new file which is tutorial 01.by. And firstly the first lesson, the first step is to import the basic library, and after that we will make it to be require some version. So kv.require 1.2.0, this is the minimum version that we want to make our file run. And after that we will import some important modules. So we will import the app, and also we want to import from kv.image.uix.image we want to import the image, and also we must import it correctly. And also we have some important module which is the loader. So from kv.loader we will import the loader. So this module is the responsible for grabbing the image from the URL. So basically you must have an URL for an image. So firstly let's go back and create this app. Feel free to name this app name as you want. So you can name it main app or something like this. Again let's go back and define the build which is the constructor. So we will define that build from self. We have an proxy image which is an image from the internet, and you will call the loader and caller call loader.image, and we have this image. So we will type here the URL. Basically I have the URL here, and let's go to grab this URL. And you can use any image URL from the internet. After that we will say that we have proxy image dot bind on load. So we will we have attached the onload event self dot image loaded like this. Alright, basically we will go here inside our main app, and you will define this event which is an image loaded such as this, and it's make its self because it part from the main app, and also it has the proxy image variable and it's accepting the proxy image because this is the image we are verifying. So if proxy image dot texture existed, so if this line is true, proxy image dot image dot texture, if there is an image from this URL and the loader has make sure that this URL has exactly an image, so we will return something. We will say that self dot image dot texture we will be the same as proxy image dot image dot texture. So what happened here? So we firstly go here and load an image, and after that we must verify that this image exists. How we can make this? If the image exists, if this image has a texture and loaded successfully, we will assign this image as a new image which is here. So self.image will be an image in Betty now, and if the image is loaded successfully, we will assign this self image which is texture. This self has texture property. We'll assign the empty texture to the new loaded texture from here. I think everything now is working properly. So we'll return the self image, which is an variable. And after that, we can now have the chance to run our app if name equals. We can now run this main app and make sure that you have the semicolon. So we will say that the main dot run. Alright, we will go here and type Python, and you have the file which is named tutorial 01, and it's loading, and it say that can't import image from KV, and let's go back kv.uix.image, and I think it's not every module has you must say that every module has the name which is first character is capital. So you will wait some moment after the image load, and you will see that the image is loaded successfully as you see here. So feel free to grab any image URL here, but there is something new. You can use an image which is actually in your hard drive. So if you have an image here, as you can see, you have icon 0. So let's try first icon 0.png, and we will not now load an image from the internet, but I think the process will be faster now because we are using an image locally. So let's close it and rerun our file again, and I think the image has been loaded successfully in a short time. And again, let's go back and use this image 0.jpg. Let's go back and type this. Let's go again and run this tutorial file, and in no time I think what is the problem that it isn't. So I think there is no image in or the image 0.1 doesn't exist. So image 0.jpg, and rerun our file, and you will see this result. So if you run this file, you will see in no time that you have this image 0.1. So that was the method for loading image inside KV. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in another tutorial. So the random module in Python is very, very helpful. Let's see how we can use it. Firstly, you should import random like this. And you are using the Python shell, and this is Python version 3. And after that, random dot rand integer starting from 2 up to 20, maybe 200, and we will generate some value from 2 to 200. You can also use any numbers, and it will usually return the value from 1 to 50 like this. And secondly, we can also use, if we have some list new like this, and we have list new, and you can also generate any list. I want to make some example, and let's say any number will be choice from this list list, and we want to get any number, and so choice isn't defined. We must say that we have random dot choice, and this will be choice from the list new. Let's now print the number. It's a 3. So as sadly and final thing, we can also print random dot random like this. So it's generating any number from 0 to 1. So these are the most useful functions: random dot random, and you have also random dot rand integer, and you have also the random dot choice. So these are the most useful functions you can use in the random module inside Python.
So what next? So if you have watched this class inside my Skillshare page, so I suggest you watching my other classes about the Flask framework and how you can make an backend for your application. If you are a beginner to backends, you can watch my class about the SQLite. So you can expect from my side to update this content if I find there is a new features have been updated in the KV framework. So I hope you enjoy this training workshop. See you in another class.